Hi, this is Galloping Gabe from Baltimore Update. Hey, we haven't been around for a while, but it's nice to see you guys again. We've been covering an awful lot of stuff, and we got a lot of stuff coming up. But we're going to break off right now with the Baltimore, Maryland Film Festival. And we got Michael Wiener here, who's one of the actors in one of the better movies that has been playing at the film festival. But you know what? We're not going to tell you anything about it. We're going to let him tell you what he wants you to know about it. So right now, let's talk to Michael Wiener. Hello, Michael.
Hey, how are you?
It's okay to call you Michael, isn't it?
Call me whatever you like.
Good. We'd like to call you Michael. And you know what? You're looking great, Michael. How are you feeling today?
Thank you very much. I'm feeling, pretty darn good. You know, a couple, besides a little wear and tear, I'm feeling well, thanks. Well,
where are you from, Michael?
Well, I'm from I'm from New York City for many, many years, and I have a lot of family history in New York City, but I actually grew up in a Chevy Chase just outside of D.C., so...
You're actually a Maryland boy. Oh, that's so funny. Okay, but you have the taste of a New York person because the way you're dressing.
Yeah, at this point, yes, I would say that I'm fairly fairly well infused with the New York sensibility. Yes.
Well, and there's nothing wrong with that, and the wardrobe looks great. Listen, I know you have a movie here at the film festival. How long have you been acting?
You know, I've gone through a lot of stages in my acting career that in New York that have involved, I was trained as a writer. And I've written for magazines. I've done I've had plays workshopped in New York, and gradually that evolved into theater and performance art and monologues and so on and so forth. In more recent years, my film I've sort of focused on my film and theater acting work in a more sort of formal, orthodox way. So it's been a many stage thing that's happened over a number of years.
Well, you know, when Entertainment Tonight comes calling, you can tell them all about all that stuff you're doing right now. But it sounds very interesting to me that you are a writer as well as all the other things you just did. Tell us about some of your earlier stuff, because eventually people are going to want to know about that. Give us a quick little rundown on your biograph.
My biograph. Let's see.
Writing.
Creative,
give us a little about
creative
the
impetuous youth with a head full of vivid imagery, sort of cosseted away in my sort of imaginary world as a child, and gradually finding ways to express that in a sort of at first sort of tumultuous and eventually cathartic way, brought me to eventually to through a wonder through an enriching childhood in Bethesda in Chevy Chase, and eventually to Washington University in St. Louis, where I received a very strong education as a writer and liberal arts student there, and brought me to New York, where I initially worked for some magazines and did envisioned taking my sort of academic mind into expository and journalistic and critical writing. Gradually this evolved into me sort of being in New York in the early to mid 90s and being people finding me interesting, I finding them interesting, realizing I didn't want to live vicariously by sort of necessarily interpreting other people's work, but in fact creating my own. I was kind of like put into different projects, into music videos and short films, and then I ended up doing some theater, and then I ended up doing this sort of autobiographical play about a guy who is writing a play about it. He's a downtown artist writing a play about his life, and the play gets produced. It's all sort of this hall of mirrors, this sort of play within a play, which I guess at that time, in my own sort of naive, nascent way, I envisioned as a vehicle of sorts, but it turned out to be sort of like an artistic education. This brought me to performance art, as I said before, brought me to some fashion and print modeling work, and then eventually to some sort of more monologues and sort of more of, you might say, a Boghossian or a Spalding Gray kind of style, autobiographical monologues with all kinds of different textures. Then eventually I started studying acting more seriously, and I kind of brought all these backgrounds together into what I see myself today as, which is sort of an adventurous film and theater actor with a lot of different kinds of training and experience. So that's where we are.
Wow, just real quickly, what was your modeling experience?
Sort of one of these sort of, I guess they were just sort of looking for sort of striking, quirky, unusual, models at that time, and especially this was in particular happening, I guess, in the late 90s or so, and I was working with photographers like Terry Richardson and stuff like that.
We obviously got that. That's great. Well, now tell me a little bit about what you got planned in the future after this, after the film festival here. You got some things coming up?
Got a bunch of things coming up, especially in New York, but I've got a couple of different festival films that have been having a lot of success internationally, including Corey McAbee's film Stingray Sam.
Well, let's talk about that for a minute. Stingray Sam. Give us a quick rundown on why we should go see that and where is it going to be playing and what is it, a feature? Is it a short? What is it?
Stingray Sam is a feature with a very unusual structure. It's an episodic film. It's a six-episode sort of styled like an old sci-fi serial. I like to call it a space western noir musical.
Space western noir musical. Let's make sure we coin that, because that is going to be a term we're going to remember for a long time. We haven't heard that before. We're going to hear it now. Please continue.
And anyway, yeah, I guest star in one of the six episodes, and I play a character called Smarmy Scientist, and Corey and I have wanted to work together for a long time. This was our first opportunity, and I'm expecting there'll be many more, because Corey has a lot of things in development. So.
Okay. Now, what you got going on in the future for yourself? What do you see yourself 5, 10 years from now?
I see myself doing much what I'm doing now, but in continued sort of expanding and continuing to sort of flesh out and realize all the direction I'm going as a film and theater actor and performer and writer, basically.
So do you have a lot coming up in theater in the next few years?
I do. I have a bunch of stuff happening in New York. Yeah.
Well, what should we look forward to? Any names we want to buzzword?
Sure. I'm working with a couple of choreographers, and we're developing some dance theater works I'm really excited about. One is a principal dancer in Jennifer Muller's company, which to those who follow dance and follow New York, they'll be familiar with it. He has a company called Flexi Curve, and we're developing a work together. And another choreographer I'm very excited about working with is Martha Williams, who has a company called The Movement. And also some playwrights that I'm being looked at for different things, and some filmmakers, and all sorts of stuff.
Well, great, Michael. I know you got to get back to New York. Yeah. It's been really nice talking to you here in the filmmaker's sauna at the Maryland Film Festival. So please make sure you check out his movie, Stingray?
Stingray Sam.
Stingray Sam. Find it wherever you can, any way you can. And be sure to keep in mind he's also on the stage and he also writes. So look for his name. We'll be seeing you around. Now you have the big picture. Thank you. Bye-bye.